So the clock is ticking down until the new MacBook Pros come out, and that is including the new 16-inch model. However, a new report has just shown the models spotted ahead of launch. Today, I want to share with you all the latest about this and also a summary of the features and of course the latest on the 2021 new MacBook Pro 16-inch release date and price. So it's October time and we're now on the final run to the next Apple event where we're most likely going to see some brand new MacBook Pros. Going forwards, I've decided for all the new MacBook Pro 16-inch videos like this one you are watching, I am going to give you the latest details on specific reports or info that has been told, then details of the planned release date time, then a summary of the models that we're going to get, and also the features that we have learnt in previous leaks, and also the prices. After, I'm going to reveal my wish list for the MacBook Pro 16-inch. Also, put in the comments below what features you'd love to see in the new MacBook Pro, and in my next video, I may feature your comment and discuss my thoughts around it. So let's start with that report of the new MacBook Pro 16-inch spotted ahead of the launch. So on the EEC database, or the Eurasian Economic Commission database, there has been a submission of 6 new Apple Watch models that mention that they're running watchOS 8, but there was also 2 MacBook Pro models listed. It's quite easy to work out that this is the new MacBooks that have just been registered are the new 2021 MacBook Pros. The new model numbers are the A2442 and the A2485. There isn't really any more info than this in the actual database of what the specs are or how they will look or, for example, screen sizes. The main thing to take away though from this is that for many years, Apple have always registered their new devices with the EEC a couple of months before launch of their new products. So this is more proof that we are going to be seeing the new MacBook Pros within the next few months. This also leads me on nicely to say that all reports and leaks are not 100% proof that they're going to come true with the new MacBooks. I can only present to you what I've been told and shown. However, if you're watching this video, then you're as curious as I am in knowing what is going to be said about the new MacBooks anyway. So continuing on with the release date. So based on Mark Gurman's recent report saying that the MacBook Pros are coming in several weeks, this is most likely going to be the case for a launch event in October and release around a week or so later. Remember, the last time we got an overall design refresh on the MacBook Pros was in October 2016. So there's a possibility for this, but the exact date, with the exception of the COVID launches in 2020 of the new M1 Max, all previous full releases of MacBooks have come at the end of October, and this has always been in the mid-20 numbers or even the first or second day into November, and it's always been a Friday. In fact, another leaker, Dylan, has also said that the end of October or early November time is on the cards. So based on this info, and remember this is on facts of other full-time MacBook releases, so remember this is not written in stone, we could, and I'll say that again, could see the new MacBooks in our hands on October 22nd or October 29th. But if we get a firm date, this of course will change, but for now this gives you a good time to base on when the release will be. So guys, really good news. We've hit over 260,000 subscribers. So I'm going to be revealing of the winner of this brand new iPad Pro to one lucky subscriber very, very soon. But just quickly, something I wanted to mention was sadly on this community and also on my videos, there are some scammers out there who are pretending to be me. They have names very similar to myself, or for example, they tell you to WhatsApp them with a phone number, as you can see some of these comments right here. I want to tell you right now, this is not me. And the best way you can check to see if it's me or not is to actually click onto the person's profile and see how many subscribers they've got. As I've just spoken about, this channel has just got over 260,000 subscribers. So if you can see that the person's only got like 3 or 4 subscribers, then you know it's definitely not me who is sending you those messages. As I have said multiple times in my videos, I'm only doing the giveaway when we hit a target amount of subscribers. So like 260,000 subscribers. So very soon I will be picking the winner. But if you do come across any of these scammers, just ignore them for the time being. And in my actual giveaway video, I'm going to be showing you a way how to get rid of those scammers altogether and help make this channel an even better community. But do stay posted, guys. I am going to be revealing who the winner is of this iPad Pro. But if you haven't yet entered, you can still enter right now. And all I want to know from you guys to get your hands possibly on this iPad Pro is basically, what Apple gear are you planning to buy in 2021? Or what Apple gear have you already bought in 2021? Write it down in the comments below, and like I said, very, very soon, I'm going to be picking a winner. And you'll know it's me, because if you click on my profile, there'll be 260,000 plus subscribers to actually be picking that person. So keep an eye out, I will be picking very soon. Let's go back to the video though. With the latest leaks and release date out of the way, let's move on to a summary of everything we know so far of previous leaks that have painted a picture of the details for the MacBook Pro 16-inch with its price as well. So these are the facts of what we know about the MacBook Pro 16-inch, and of course this could change over time, so make sure you do check out my videos in the future. But anyway, we're expecting a 16-inch XDR Liquid Retina Mini LED display. This is very similar to the display that we find in the iPad Pro 12.9-inch, and it will feature a resolution of 3072 by 1920, exactly what we get in the standard LED display in the current MacBook Pro 16-inch. However, the difference is most likely we're going to be getting ProMotion 120Hz refresh rate with this. On top, for storage options, they will start from 512GB all the way up to 8TB of storage. Then most likely we're going to be getting our M1X chipset inside it, what will be a 12-core CPU, and also will feature a 16 or 32-core GPU option depending on the amount of RAM that you pick. And talk about RAM, the options of RAMs will be 16GB, 32GB or 64GB of RAM. It is most likely that the 32-core GPU option will be available with 32 or 64GB of RAM. We're also going to be getting a brand new design with the MacBook Pro 16-inch, and it will be made out of an aluminium body. And you've seen this new design and what it could potentially look like in the renders in this video. For ports, MagSafe is back at last, but at the same time as well, we'll be getting 3 USB-C ports, and these will be Thunderbolt 4 ports. That's one less than what we get on the MacBook Pro right now, but we will get the return of HDMI 2.1 and also an SD card slot. At the same time, the webcam in the center is going to be that new center stage webcam that will be a 12 megapixel camera. The battery life from the latest leaks that we've been told will be an 8,693 milliamp. So for prices, because things can be a bit of a mix-up depending on what options you pick, I've based this on the lowest amount of RAM, what you can get, and then going up in the storage amounts. So the prices will start at $2,399 for a 512GB option, for 1TB, $2,099, 2TB, $2,999, 4TB, $3,599, and 8TB, $4,799. So that is a summary of the MacBook Pro 16-inch. However, for my thoughts and wishes, my wish is actually to do with the price. Now, over the years, the 16-inch MacBook Pro has gone up and has creeped up quite a bit. So the current base model now starts at $2,400, and if we go back just around that 8 years ago, it started at $1,800. I am hoping that Apple can at least keep the same price and not increase the cost of the next generation MacBook Pro 16-inch. But let me know your thoughts if you agree with this or not, and write in the comments below your wishes what you'd like to see in the new MacBook Pro 16-inch. Well guys, it's also time to wrap up this video, so if you have enjoyed watching it, please make sure to like the video, and at the same time, if you want to hear the latest Apple news, reviews and comparisons, please make sure to hit the subscribe button followed by the notification bell. Until next time guys, see you soon.